So we're here today with Dan Turbeck, who is a council member on Berkeley City Council, who is now running for mayor. How you doing today?
Doing great, Crystal. How are you?
Good, good. Thanks for coming out. Can you talk a little bit about how long have you been on council and what are some of the things that you've accomplished?
Sure. I was first elected for council 10 years ago, actually, in 2007, when I was in my 20s. And you know, what prompted me to even run for council is lived in Berkeley my entire life. I'm a third generation Berkeley resident, currently raising what I hope will be the fourth generation with my wife and my three daughters. And I wanted to give back to the community that gave me so much growing up. Started out on the Recreation Advisory Board, was on that for a couple years, and then decided to run for council and was fortunate enough to be elected by the residents of Berkeley and then subsequently re-elected. And now I am running for mayor.
Yeah, what has prompted you to decide to run for mayor?
So in my professional career outside of the city of Berkeley, I was a teacher and a principal for 10 years, 5 years as a teacher. And I love teaching. I love the impact that I was having on the kids. But I felt like I could have more of an impact on the school building if I was principal, if I was an administrator. So that's what drove me to that. And it's pretty similar. I'm on council. I'm pretty proud of what we've been able to accomplish in my 10 years on council. The community centerpiece ordinance, which protects our green space, is something I'm very proud of. I was mayor pro tem for 6 years. I was the chairperson of a subcommittee on the roads and water, which we are now seeing finally something come to fruition on that. I was the chairperson of a subcommittee to hire a new city attorney, and also the chairperson of the subcommittee to hire a new city manager. On top of that, the city of Berkeley, we're very fortunate. We have received a number of accolades over the past 5 years, especially for being best, most affordable suburb, a safe city, and a whole slew in between. And I think, you know, that's a testament to what we've been able to do as a council, but also as a city, and certainly in collaboration with the businesses and the school district. And I'm hoping that as mayor, I will be able to, again, have that impact, maybe have a little more of an impact than I have as a council member, and really have an opportunity to express my vision for the future of Berkeley. And like I said, my kids, I hope, are going to be the fourth generation. And I realize that decisions that I make now will impact not only today, but also impact their Berkeley for the future. And it's really a shared vision for me. It's my vision, but it's also what the residents of Berkeley want Berkeley to look like in the future, and I think that's critical.
So what are some of the issues and challenges that you'll be taking on if you're elected?
Sure. So we know right now we had a citizens advisory committee that was studying some major issues. You know, infrastructure is something that we've been looking at for a number of years, figuring out how we can not only fix what we have now, but also preserve and maintain for the future as well. So we're looking at some roads and water initiatives right now. The Citizens Advisory Committee also studied a new community center and recommended that council take a look at a ballot issue for a new community center, which I think you know, the community needs. Demographically, we're changing a little bit. We seem to have a lot of, you know, new development and new houses, and a lot of young families and kids are coming in, and it's you know, sometimes people assume that Parks and Recreation is only supposed to serve the kids, but it's also for everybody, certainly our senior population as well. And I think we need to have more recreational opportunities for them as well. And then it's looking at facilities. City Hall is something that is being looked at, but I think it's more of our city facilities in general that we need to make sure that we're keeping an eye on. And as I mentioned before, you know, really a big issue for me as well is our vision, is what is our shared vision of Berkeley? What do we want Berkeley to be in the future in terms of the types of businesses, working with the DDA and the chamber? What do we want that, you know, the downtown to look like? What do we want our zoning to look like? And, you know, it's the shared vision of the residents and council to make sure that that all comes to fruition. It's not just one person saying, this is what I want. It has to be a conversation. There has to be dialogue. And I'm excited to engage in
so
that.
So at this time, we don't yet know if anybody's running against you because the petitions are not due yet.
Sure.
But why should people vote for you?
Well, the biggest thing, I feel like for a resident to vote for you, they have to trust you. You have to be able to build a rapport. And I feel like over the past 10 years and also living in the city my entire life, you know, it helps to help bridge that trust. And I know that there are a number of issues that happen in cities, and we have some of those in Berkeley right now, that, you know, there may be differences of opinion from residents, and maybe, you know, maybe there's council members, they might not necessarily think that they align. And I think that's where having that dialogue and open communication is most important. Doesn't mean that people are always going to agree on everything. That's not realistic. But I feel, you know, I believe that you have to be able to articulate why you believe in something and then have that conversation. And, you know, looking at my track record as a council member of the past 10 years and 6 years as mayor pro tem and the things that I mentioned earlier, and, you know, ultimately comes down to trusting us, trusting me as a mayor, and most importantly, trusting us as stewards of the residents' money. And I'm incredibly proud that we have a balanced budget, that we continue to maintain our fund balance. We're keeping an eye on our long-term legacy costs, and we are still planning for the future with a pretty aggressive capital improvements program. And I think all of those things help residents to get to know me as a person, get to know why it's so important to me, why I've been involved for so long, and why I want to continue to be involved in this great community.
If people want more information about you or your campaign, how can they get information?
They can go to my Facebook page right now, Dan Terbeck for Mayor on Facebook, and my official website will be, it's in production right now, it will be up shortly. And people can find me anywhere around the city, anytime they want to talk.
Perfect. Well, thank you for coming out today. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Crystal.